Okay, I think everyone is there. Okay, so we'll start. Okay, so I think everyone is there. Okay, we'll start with compartment syndrome. Oh, you can hear my audio. Okay, so we'll start with compartment. I don't know whether you have issue or nothing. Okay, we'll start with compartment syndrome. Okay, so how to know what is compartment syndrome? So any of the limb or any issue, okay, any of the limb is form of compartment. Okay, so if you think of this is as your lower limb, okay, so they are anterior compartment. Okay, so it can be anterior compartment, then there can be in a posterior compartment. So anterior compartment, posterior compartment, and medial compartment. Okay, there's three compartments in the lower limbs. Okay, that's why adductor canal or that area, medial part, posterior is hamstring and anterior is quadriceps. Okay, so there's three compartments. Okay, so what is compartment syndrome? So if there is any problem in the any compartment, like so any compartment is filled of like muscles, bone. Okay, so bone is there are muscles are there. So consider if there's a muscles here. Okay, consider this is a muscle. Okay, so if there's any trauma to the muscles, okay, so the edema will start happening. Okay, so up to a limit, the skin, the muscles will be stretched. Up to a limit, the skin will be stretched. Okay, but after that limit, it cannot stretch. Okay, and from the posterior side or from one side, there is a interosseous membrane which is not very much relaxed. Okay, so it is very tense or something like that. Okay, so now the pressure would start increasing in one compartment. As soon as the pressure would start increasing in one compartment, there are blood vessels of this shape. Okay, when the pressure start increasing, it will start compressing the blood vessels. Now the blood vessels will become this. After more compression, it will become like this. Okay, as soon as the compression is increased, the blood vessel will start compressing. The blood vessel start compressing, the blood flow will decrease. As soon as the blood flow will decrease, it is again destroying the muscles. Okay, it start again destroying the muscles of ischemia and necrosis. Okay, as soon as the ischemia and necrosis increase, again it increases. So it is a vicious cycle. So initially, is there any trauma to the limb or any fracture to the limb? There is a muscle trauma, there is a bone trauma, there is edema, there is a bleeding. Okay, so any bleeding, edema start increasing. Okay, up to a limit, the compartment withstand that pressure. Okay, but after a certain limit, if the edema blood is more than limit, okay, so there will be automatically compression of the nerves. The nerve will be start compressing, the blood vessels will start compressing. As soon as the blood vessels start compressing, the blood flow decrease, the muscle will go into ischemia, necrosis, then again that edema will start. So it is a vicious cycle. Okay, so compartment syndrome may normally you don't feel. So if this is because of, see, if you have a fracture here, okay, so if this is the ये देखो सारा स्वेलिंग है. ओके, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस स्वेलिंग देयर आर नो ब्लड फ्लो टू द दिस डिस्टल. सो इफ यू यहाँ पे आर्टरी डॉर्सली स्पेडिस, इफ यू पैल्पेट दिस डॉर्सली स्पेडिस, यू डोंट फील एनी पल्सेशन इन डॉर्सली स्पेडिस. ओके, सो यू फील पल्सलेसनेस. ओके, ऑल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ द नर्व्स देयर, सो देयर इज एंटीरियर टीबियल नर्व एंड मेनी नर्व्स, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस नर्व्स कॉजिंग लाइक डॉर्सिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द फुट. ओके, बिकॉज ऑफ द नर्व कंप्रेशन एंड वैस्कुलर कंप्रेशन, यू कैनॉट फील एनी पल्स. Because of the neural compression, you cannot feel the movement of the limbs. Okay, so the limb will become more tense. Okay, there is no pulse. There will be neural injury. Neural problems would be there. It will become very stretched and very stretched. There may be blips or what you say, pustules can be there. Okay, so this is known as compartment syndrome. So any fracture, it's not related to any fracture, but mostly it's related to fracture like. So in supracondylar, because there's bachu mein, it's very easily missed, bachu mein compartment syndrome. So the compartment syndrome clinically, how you know this is compartment syndrome? the patient would have severe pain. Severe pain means severe pain. You can give diclofenac, buvirun, paracetamol, any drug you give, the pain will not be relieved. Okay. So the, if the pain is too much, that is not relieved by even painkillers. Okay. If there is a stretch pain means if there is a problem of this limb and if you do the dorsiflexion of the foot, the patient will have severe pain. So if there is a passive stretch pain, Anna, first. The second is too much of analgesics, use of too much of analgesics. Okay. These two is totally, and third is pulselessness of distal pulse. The fourth one is maybe neural injury. Okay. This all leads to compartment syndrome. Okay. So in supracondylar fracture, there may be a complication of compartment syndrome. Okay. So what is the treatment of compartment syndrome? The role of why, what is this compartment syndrome? Kyun hota hai? Because पीछे इधर फेशियल लगा हुआ है एंड आगे द स्किन इज स्ट्रेच्ड अप टू लिमिट इट कैन नॉट बी स्टिल सो व्हाट इज द ट्रीटमेंट यू कट द फेशिया ओके सो यू डू फेशियोटोमी तो फेशियोटोमी टोमी इज ओपनिंग ऑफ द फेशिया सो दैट प्रेशर वुड डिसिपेट ओके आई विल शो यू द सो सी दिस सो दिस इज फोर कंपा दिस इज लेग्स ओके सो यू जस्ट ओपन दिस You just open this. So, यहाँ का fascia open किया, यहाँ का fascia open किया. The pressure will automatically dissipate. Okay. So, और इसको suture भी नहीं करते. Skin को खोल, इसको just keep it open as such as so that the edema would decrease. So, this is known as fasciotomy. Fasciotomy बोलते हैं इसको. Fasciotomy of compartment syndrome. So, supracondylar humerus fracture में one of the complication is fasciotomy. Okay, it's also present in the limbs, lower limbs, and everything. Then obviously the nerve and vessels injury. I had already told you brachial injury, brachial artery injury is common. Nerve injury, I had already told you extension type. It is median nerve, flexion type. It is ulnar nerve, and median maybe AIN is most common. Okay. Then there's a Volkmann ischemic contracture. Okay, what do you mean by contracture? Contracture means if there is any issue. Okay, if there is any issue in which your limbs will go into contracture. Contracture is somewhere, it is a very chronic type of process where the limb remain in that position. You cannot make it reversible. Okay. It go into the contracture. Okay. Contract position. Why Volkmann ischemic contracture is one of the complications of compartment syndrome. So if you have a compartment syndrome, okay, or if you see burns, okay. So burns mein kya hota hai? What happens in burns? There's a lot of high temperature. The skin got burn. Okay. Now the muscles. So once they go into muscle, the burning tissue, they start contracting the muscle. Okay. So muscles bahut contract ho jate hai, and the limb would be in some position. And because of the neural injury and the muscle contracture, the body will go into such either flexion attitude or whatever attitude that is known as contracture. So Volkmann ischemic contracture kya hota hai? So see, word you should remember the word, the ischemic contracture bolte hai. Ischemic. Okay, ischemic means decreased blood supply. So if there is a compartment syndrome in the supracondylar, you consider supracondylar fracture hua, and there is a decreased blood supply to this area. Okay, there is a nerve damage also because of the compartment syndrome. Sometimes there is a nerve damage also. So there is a nerve damage. There is a muscles necrosis, ischemia. Muscles ko ischemia hota hai because the blood vessels are not acting properly. So the muscles got into contracture. There is a nerve issue. Okay. In which the limbs go into such position. This is a totally typical median of palsy or some palsy, okay, and related with the muscle contracture. So this is Volkmann ischemic contracture, VIC is ko bolte hain. This is mainly problem of compartment syndrome. So after compartment syndrome, you can have this VIC. So in supracondylar humerus fracture, you can have compartment syndrome, you can have VIC. Okay. So the other factor is malunion. Okay, so there's three union. Okay, again I have to teach you. So what is union? What is non-union? What is malunion? So see, this is your, if this is your normal bone. Okay, if this is your normal bone, you got a. If this is your normal bone, okay, if you got fracture here, okay, if you got fracture here, okay. So यहाँ पे ऐसा फ्रैक्चर हो गया ओके सो समटाइम्स इफ फ्रैक्चर इज नॉट डिस्प्लेस्ड डिस्प्लेस मीन्स डिस्प्लेस्ड ओके सो इट इज नॉट डिस्प्लेस्ड एंड there's a fracture, so it will unite in the same direction mein unite ho jata hai. Okay, so this is union. Okay, it is union. Okay, sometimes if it is the fracture, it displaced. Okay, so fracture agar displaced hai, so consider this. So this is fracture ka one fragment, the proximal fragment ye maan lo, and the distal fragment think of displaced. Okay, yahan displaced. Okay, distal fragment. Now still fracture can unite. Okay, now still the fracture can unite in this position as a fracture unite ho jata. So now your limb would be in malunion. So this is known as malunion. Aisa ho jata limb. Instead of straight limb, you have this aisa tedha ho jata limb. That is known as malunion. Okay, this is malunion. So it is a malunion is union. Union is united. If it is not in true alignment, so AL is alignment, M is missed alignment. You can as a layman you can remember this. M for missed, AL for alignment, union. So if alignment is not proper, so if there's a fracture and the fracture unites in proper alignment, jaisa tha waisa hi jud gaya. So this is true. This is true union. Okay. If it is united into thoda sa aisa tedha, so that is malunion. Okay, so malunion hota hai. So now, so one of the common complication of supracondylar humerus is malunion. Okay, so now there is a cubitus varus and valgus. Okay, so I had already told you what is varus and valgus. Okay. So ye bacche, you see, this limb should be aisa straight hona chahiye, but it is gun stock deformity. Gun stock matlab, what is gun stock means? Okay. So see, this is gun stock. Ye gun hai na, ye stock. Gun stock deformity bolte hai isko. So gun stock deformity is typical in aisa hota hai. So if consider, ye iska true hai. Okay. So normally, if you see your elbow, okay, you see there is a slight outward. So normally, our limbs go into this direction. 7 degree 8 degree ऐसा valgus रहता है हमारा, ये normal रहता है, इतना valgus normal रहता है. Okay, so 7 8 degree का valgus रहता है normally. If it is going inside, it is varus. It is going outside, it is valgus. So normally in supracondylar humerus, limb inside जाता है, अंदर की तरफ जाता है. So it is a varus deformity. Okay, it is known as gun stock deformity. देखो gun stock में ऐसा. So you remember, if you don't remember anything, you just remember gun stock or varus deformity. Okay. So this is a long barrel gun stock deformity. Okay. So how will you treat any deformity? Okay. So now see, in a deformity, what is the problem? It is now united. Okay. So bone अभी ऐसा unite हो गया. ऐसा bone unite हो गया. हमें क्या करना है इसको? हमें इसको सीधा करना है. Okay. So there's two way of doing it. One is कि आप इतना portion cut कर दे, इतना portion cut कर दे, और इसको अभी आपका माल यूनियन में हो गया, ऐसे ऐसे जुड़ गया, ऐसे ये बोन जुड़ गया, मान लो ये जुड़ गया, ये बोन जुड़ गया. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट विल यू डू, हम क्या करते हैं, इसको ऐसे कट कर देते हैं. ओके, ये मीडियल साइड है, लैटरल साइड है, मान लो इधर मीडियल साइड से हम इतना कट कर दिए. ओके, कट करने के बाद क्या हुआ, इसको हटा दिए. ओके, अभी ये फ्रैगमेंट, सो नाउ विल ट्राई टू मोबिलाइज दिस फ्रैगमेंट इनटू द सेम अलाइनमेंट. सो कैसे करेंगे, सो इफ यू कंसीडर इसको हटा देने का, नाउ उसको पकड़ के हम सीधा कर देंगे. ओके, नाउ विल कीप दैट लिम इनटू सीधा, एंड यहाँ प्लास्टर या जो भी ऑपरेशन रहेगा वो कर देंगे. ओके, and after that time it will unite. Okay, so any deformity you had to operate. Okay, without operating you cannot do any deformity. So osteotomy means kya hota hai, what is osteotomy? Osteo means bone, tomy means opening. So you cut that part of bone either from medial side ya fir lateral side se bhi cut kar sakte hain, you would surgeon dependent. Okay, so if medial side you are scared of ulnar nerve, you go from lateral side. The lateral side you are scared of radial nerve, you come from medial side. So any side you can go, you do an osteotomy and you correct that bone. Okay, you just manipulate that bone into the true alignment, and that is known as osteotomy. So any deformity, any malunion, the answer is osteotomy for you, for your level. Okay, so this is Gunstock deformity. So there's an osteotomy name hota hai. So this is French osteotomy. So yaad rakhna, this is some French. Okay, so what do you see? Ye hota hai lateral open. So radius hai, radius is lateral side. So lateral se itna hum log kholte hain, open karte hain, and you just isko aisa kar dete hain. So you see ye aisa hai angle. Now the angle we change into this angle, aisa change kar dete. Now it will becomes aisa change ho jayega, aisa straight ho jayega, ye becomes straight ho jayega. इसको ऐसे स्ट्रेट कर देंगे, ओके, सो वी चेंज दैट एंगल, ओके, फ्रॉम मीडियल टू लैटरल, ओके, ये इसके ऊपर दबा देंगे ऐसे, सो दिस इज द सर्जरी, ऑस्टियोटॉमी बोलते हैं इसको, द ऑस्टियोटॉमी सर्जरी फॉर माल यूनियन, ओके, सो देयर इज टू नेम्स ऑफ ऑस्टियोटॉमी, यू शुड रिमेंबर वन नेम एटलीस्ट, फ्रेंच ऑस्टियोटॉमी, ओके, सो समटाइम्स दे आस्क व्हाट इज द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ क्यूबाइटस वायरस. So cubitus virus, if the answer is osteotomy, it's always osteotomy. It can be medial, it can be from medial side, from lateral side, both is okay. Okay, but most commonly they ask one name, I say like French or King, whatever. So you most commonly French osteotomy we do. Okay, French osteotomy is something easy. We all love France. So France, you just remember French osteotomy. Go to France.
Not now, sir.
Huh?
आप नहीं love करते France.
Okay, for this you remember French, later on don't remember. Okay, so the next is what is myositis ossificans? Okay, so again this is some small complication of fracture. So myo is muscle. Okay, so myo means muscle, itis means inflammation, ossification means ossified बोलते हैं, मतलब bone का formation, ossification जिसको बोलते हैं, bone formation. मसल इन्फ्लामेशन लीडिंग टू ऑसिफिकेशन. मसल के अंदर कोई भी इन्फ्लामेशन हुआ जिसके कारण ऑसिफिकेशन हुआ मसल में. सो इफ दिस इज मसल, ओके, मसल में क्या हुआ, हमने इन्फ्लामेशन किया, कैसे इन्फ्लामेशन किया, आइदर इट कैन बी डन बाय सम टॉक्सिन, ट्रॉमा, इन्फेक्शन, एनीवेयर. सो मसल में लेकिन होना चाहिए, मसल में देयर इज इन्फ्लामेशन हुआ, मसल में सारे न्यूट्रोफिल्स, माइक्रोफेजेस all will enter into muscle and later on they all organize and start forming bone. Okay, so your muscle will become bone. Okay, so this is known as myositis ossificans. Okay, myositis, once the muscle will become bone, obviously there would be stiffness. Okay, so see, these are the muscles, these are the normal bones, ye normal bones hai, yahan se ye normal bones hai. Okay, ye sorry, these are the normal bones and this surrounding, ye sab jitne bhi droplets hai, sare, these all are muscles. Okay, so ye muscles mein sare ye sab form हो गया, ये सारे, all these are muscles. So these all white 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 things are myositis ossificans. ये muscles में सारे bony formation. That's why if you got any injury to your limb or your muscles or whatever, like sometimes you got injury on while playing on your knee joint or your thigh, people try to massage it. Never massage your muscles. Okay, never massage your muscles. It's a common phenomenon in our household that people usually massage that, either child or something. But in orthopedic, never, never massage that muscles or yeah, because whenever you massage, the body go into myositis ossificans. So you avoid doing massage. Okay, so this thing you should remember. Any trauma to your any muscle. Okay, never massage. Whenever you do massage, you started the process of myositis ossificans, and it will form bone. And once it will be form bone, you cannot do anything. Okay, it will obviously become stiff. You have to remove that bone, or you will become a stiff joint. So in elbow, you see there is a formation. This is the normal bone. Okay, so this is the normal bone. This is the normal bone. Okay, and this whole chunk is a bone, myositis ossificans. Here also, you see this whole chunk is a myositis ossificans. Okay, so in children, where supracondylar humerus, the mother or some family person usually massage that area, and it will totally form bone, and it will make your elbow stiff. So myositis ossificans is a complication of also this. Now supracondylar humerus already over. Okay, so if you want to revise, you can revise again. Okay, just fast revision of supracondylar humerus. Okay. So supracondylar humerus. So above condyle, there is a part known as supracondylar area. Okay, that is supracondylar fracture. okay, mainly outstretched hand, elbow in a hyperextension. Okay, there is two type of fracture. Obviously, one is extension, one is flexion. Extension is always the distal segment, the distal fragment is this fragment, will go into posteriorly, and in flexion, the distal will go anteriorly. Most common is extension because elbow is in extension mode, so extension fracture. The displacement would be posteriorly and it will be proximally. And here is the median nerve. Aata hai. See, median nerve goes into this area. Okay, so this will directly injure the median nerve. It's okay. You just remember this. This is proximal part, this is distal part. Distal part posterior gaya, proximal part anterior gaya. Proximal ka part ke paas yahan pe aata hai median nerve, it will directly injure the median by his spikes. Okay, so this is most common extension fracture. Okay, now come for the next thing. The same thing, supracondylar, posterior, postromedial is the most common part of in posterior. Okay, now clinically you have this fat pad sign, dono side mein pad aata hai, fat pad aata hai, posteriorly bhi, anteriorly bhi. Now there's a dimple sign or puckering because of ye muscles se ye, because this bone will come out of the muscle and start poking the skin. Okay, then there's a garden classification. Garden may, if you fall in garden while in a hyperextension mode, so it is type 1 is non-displaced, type 2 is slightly displaced with posteriorly there is a continuity, and type 3 is total displacement. Okay, so cast type 1 and type 2 you can cast. Okay, there is no problem because one side there is a continuity in type 2, so you can cast in type 2 also, but type 3 you have to operate it. So operate, K wire putting is not a big thing, but now the problem is whether you open it and put K wire or from outside you put a K wire. If you, so it can be CRIF, closed reduction internal fixation, it can be open reduction internal fixation, so both can be, you can. Okay, the complication is brachial artery injury. Now in the nerve you go into most common extension, posterior, median nerve, and in median nerve which branch? It is AIN. In posterior inflection type it is mainly ulnar nerve. Then compartment syndrome, whenever a compartment there is a muscle ischemia, the pressure increases, when the pressure increases it will compress the nerve, the muscles, the blood vessels compress, it will go into ischemia, nerve compress, it will go into palsy. So if there is a ischemia of the muscles, it will cause Volkmann ischemic contracture. So what is the treatment? Obviously there is a fascia, the issue is fascia, remove the fascia, fasciotomy. Okay, then Volkmann ischemic contracture because of the compartment syndrome. Okay, what is malunion? It is a union of the bone, but in M for missed alignment. So missed alignment, the bone united into some varus or valgus deformities. What is varus? What is valgus? Valgus is L, that is lateral deviated, any outside. Okay, so joint ke distally jo bhi outside jayega, that is valgus. Andar aaya varus. So limbs, isme gun stock deformity hota hai. This is gun stock deformity. Now what is the treatment of this gun stock deformity? Is we cut this part. Ye part cut karke and will make it straight. Okay, so hardly any issue. This is known as a French osteotomy because we love French. Okay, then what is myositis ossificans? The fusion, the muscle inflammation leading to osteogenesis. Now second thing is lateral condyle of humerus fracture. Okay, so this is very boring, but still you have to study this. So these are the condyles. Okay, so there's a two condyles of the humerus. One is medial condyle, one is lateral condyle. How will you differentiate which condyle is which? You see the radius bone. Okay, so radius bone is on lateral side. Okay, so this is radius, this is radius, this is radial head. Okay, it is circular. So this is lateral side and this is medial side. Okay, so this part ye jo part dikh raha hai, this is fracture. Okay, you are looking of this part. But this part, ये अभी primary osteogenesis हो रहा है, means these are primary ossification centers, it has not fused. Okay, don't be confused because nobody asks you to identify fracture and ossification center. It's for postgraduate. For you, you just remember radial head side में जो भी आया, that is lateral condyle fracture होता है. Okay, so it can be medial condyle fracture, it can be lateral condyle fracture. Okay, दोनों sides हो सकते हैं. Okay, so कैसा fractures कैसा होता है? So there's a different type of fractures. I will just outline you. So if this is fracture, this is lateral condyle fracture. If this is fracture, this is medial condyle fracture. Sometimes fractures come like this. Aisa. So it is intercondylar fracture. So ek condyle, dono condyle remove ho jayenge, and it is intercondylar, in between the condyles. So it can be fracture can be medial condyle fracture, fracture can be lateral condyle fracture, fracture can be intercondylar fracture, and out of all there is a supracondylar fracture. So ye upar ho gaya supracondylar, this is intercondylar fracture, this is medial condyle, this is lateral condyle. Okay, so lateral condyle fracture ke bare mein karo, this is very easy to miss, but because you cannot, it is easy to miss because you cannot differentiate between some ossification center and fractures. Okay, that's why it is easy to miss by some MBBS or amateur orthopedic surgeons. Okay, so this is young children's, the same supracondylar ki tarah inme young children's hota hai, less than 10. Okay, so classification, there's a Milch classification. Okay, how will you remember Milch? So you just remember, so what is Garden classification or Gartner bolte na, Gartner classification, that is because of SC humerus, supracondylar humerus. Okay, now the second classification is Milch. I go with this. So see, if Milch you go for LC, okay, so it is like lateral condyle. Okay, LC is lateral condyle. Okay, lateral condyle. Okay, and H4 humerus. Okay, so LCH. So Milch bolte isko LCH. So lateral condyle of humerus is Milch classification. Okay, so this is a Milch classification. Now it's going to some epiphyseal injury, but you don't remember all that because it's type 1 is type 4. There's epiphyseal injury. Okay, so I'm just outlining what it means. So there is a epiphysis, there is a metaphysis, there is a diaphysis. Lateral condyle of humerus in children's, because we are talking of children below 10 years, there is epiphysis area. Okay, so in epiphysis injuries are, there are many types of epiphysis injury. So I will teach you what are the type of epiphysis injury, but for Milch you just remember lateral condyle humerus, Milch classification. If you want to remember, you just remember for MCQ purpose, type 2 is type 2 and type 1 is type 4. I don't know how can you remember. Okay. Type 1 is type 4 and type 2 is type 2. Now go again. So in lateral condyle also the fractures classification are same. Stage 1, don't do anything, put a plaster and come out. Okay, because it is undisplaced. Stage 2, slightly displaced. You can put a plaster, you can put a K wire also, CRIF. Okay. Stage 3 is totally displaced, rotated, you have to operate it. Okay, so you have to do ORIF and CRIF, whatever. Okay. And lateral condyle fracture is a fracture of necessity. Why it is a fracture of necessity? This is very important word. Okay, so lateral condyle fracture is why it is so much important, because it is always missed by by orthopedic surgeon. So lateral condyle humerus is always missed by orthopedic surgeon because they get confused by this, either it is ossification center or it is a fracture, because displaced or undisplaced, there is a lot of problems. Okay, so it is a fracture of necessity, so you had to identify it, and you had to operate it, so it is a fracture of necessity. If you don't operate, what happens? So this is x-ray, you see the fracture is there. Okay, this is radius. Okay, see, this is radius. So this is lateral side. Okay. So complication. Okay, so there's a complication. So how will you know whether it will go into varus and valgus? Okay, so see, this is your elbow. Okay, this is your humerus, this is your radius, this is your ulna. Okay, so if there's a fracture of this area, okay, so fracture of this area, so what happens? So this area grows. Okay, so the condyles ka kya meaning hota hai? So condyles meaning hota hai ki they are the epiphyseal center. I will show you. These are the condyles. Okay, so ye epiphysis center hota hai. Yahan growing problem hota hai. Yahan grow hota hai. So this is radius. Okay, ye maan lo radius hai. This is ulna. Okay, this is ulna. Okay, so if this is fractured, okay, yahan fracture hoke ye separate ho gaya. This part is separated. So now the growth in this area is stopped. Okay. But ye area, the medial area will start growing. Okay, so as soon as this length start growing, okay, ye length grow ho raha hai and this length is not growing, so what happens? The distal part will start tilting into this direction. okay, you just it's a you use common sense. Okay, so this part is not growing. Okay, this part is not growing. ये बंद हो गया. ये this part is growing. बंद हो गया. This part start growing. Okay, so up to a limit it will grow. Okay, up to a limit it will grow. But as soon as he sees कि दिया यहाँ पे problem चल रहा है, deficiency है, so the body will start going into that direction. Every direction you the see grow body grows in that direction which is very deficient or where they find there is no resistance. Okay, so this area there is no resistance. If there is a resistance from this area also, it will grow into distally. Distally jitna grow karta. But since it if have the problem into this area, the body into go outside. Okay, and this is totally lateral deviation. Okay, so there is a valgus deformity. So lateral condyle humerus have valgus deformity, while the supracondylar have that varus deformity. If you don't be confused, then you just remember only one thing: L is L and L. So it is Milch classification, MILCH classification. It is lateral condyle fracture. It is lateral deviation or valgus, VALGUS, valgus. Okay. Yes, Kritika, you can ask. Hello.
Nothing, sir. Nothing.
Okay. You just try to see some problems. Okay. Anyway, okay. So, so you have this. Okay. So the complications is one is so you remember that one. Okay. So non-union and mal-union. Okay. So non-union, mal-union, the same thing. So mal-union is more common than non-union. So sometimes there is a non-union chances also in supracondylar. In supracondylar also non-union can happen, but most commonly mal-union happens. Okay, in lateral condyle humerus also, if you don't operate, it will go into non-union, and if you operate, it will go into mal-union. Okay, so there is a problem. If you don't operate, it will go into non-union. क्योंकि ऐसा होता है ये पार्ट ऐसा सेपरेटेड है. ओके, इफ यू डोंट ऑपरेट इट विल गो इनटू नॉन यूनियन. इफ यू ऑपरेट बाय के वायर और समथिंग, समटाइम्स इट विल बिल इन गो इनटू माल यूनियन, वेलगस मिडल आ जाता है. ओके, एंड देयर इज अ टार्डी अल्नर पल्स. ओके, सो समथिंग आई हैव टू एक्सप्लेन दिस थिंग. व्हाट इज टार्डी अल्नर पल्स? टार्डी मींस क्या होता है? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय टार्डी? ओके, सो टार्डी मींस क्या होता है? टार्डी मींस लेट. Okay, tardy means late hota hai. So there is problem of late ulnar palsy. How ulnar palsy hota hai, main tumhe bata. Okay, so see, this is the valgus deformity. So this is the valgus deformity. Okay. Okay. Can you see na? So ulnar nerve kidhar aata hai? Ulnar nerves come inside. Okay, ulnar nerve andar ki taraf aata hai. Okay, so as soon as your body is going into normal ye aisa hai, normal apna limb aisa hai. This is your ulnar nerve. Okay, with time kya hoga? More valgus ja raha hai. So your ulnar nerve will slightly stretch. Okay, with time it is going more valgus. Okay, or valgus hota hai. Now the nerve will totally be stretched. Okay, so tardy ulnar nerve palsy kya hota hai? Tardy means hota hai late. Okay, tardy means hota hai late. So initially there is no ulnar nerve palsy, but as soon as the valgus component start increasing in life, dheere dheere badhna chalu hoga, the nerve will start stretching, and after 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, the nerve will totally stretch, and as soon as the nerve will stretch, there will be palsy. So it is known as tardy ulnar nerve palsy. Tardy means late. You can use tardy into radial nerve palsy also. You can use tardy into any nerve palsy. Tardy means late hota hai. So now tardy ulnar nerve palsy, with time the valgus component increases, the nerve starts stretching out, and that is known as tardy ulnar nerve palsy. Okay, is samajh aaya kya tumko tardy ulnar nerve palsy? If not, then please let me know. Okay, so again we'll go to lateral condyle fracture. So lateral condyle fracture is lateral type of fracture. It is very missed fracture, because obviously you see this is more you think of fracture, but it is ossification and it is fracture. So it is most commonly missed by orthopedic surgeon. That's why it is a fracture of necessity. You had to operate this fracture. If you operate, if you don't operate, it will go into non-union. If you operate, it will go into malunion. Okay. So this is lateral humeral condyle fracture. Okay. More than less than 6 years, MILF classification, a MILF classification, type 1, type 2, CH, LCH. So L is lateral, C for condyle, H for humerus. So lateral condyle humerus classification. Type 1 is type 4 of epiphyseal injury, type 2 is type 2. So you remember this. Fracture of necessity. Stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, 2, 3 you operate, 1 you conserve, okay. X-ray, okay. Complication, totally non-union, malunion. You have cubatus valgus deformity. I already told you cube valgus hota hai. Because ek side mein khali rata hai, so the body grows into that side. And later on, it will lead to ulnar nerve palsy, which is known as tardy ulnar nerve palsy. Now, what is pulled elbow? So, pulled elbow is mainly found in children who is playing with father. Okay, so any MCQ, if the MCQ is like that, a child which is playing with his father, okay, start paining in the elbow area. What is your diagnosis? The diagnosis is pulled elbow. So, father means pulling. Okay, so pulled elbow is a typical problem of in children where father or whatever, the servant or anybody, start pulling this leg, limb, okay, the hand of the child, okay. So while pulling, the what they do, the radial side, there's an annular ligament. I had already told you the radial head is encased in an annular ligament in the fossa, okay. So whenever you pull, the radial head get pulled out of that ligament, okay, and they start paining in the elbow region. So it is like 1 to 4 year, okay, painful movements, okay. So radial head pulled out of annular ligament. Okay, the force is always longitudinal or axial. So see, this is longitudinal or axial traction force. Okay, the limb is always in extension and pronation. So it is extension. Obviously, it is an extension. Pronation may rehta hai. Okay. So what is the treatment of pulled elbow? You just remember pulled elbow ka treatment kya hota hai? If the patient comes with the pulled elbow, you just supinate the forearm. Okay. As soon as you supinate the forearm, it will go into the annular ligament. The radial head will go into the annular ligament and the baby will stop crying. So pulled ligament is mainly in small children where the annular ligament is totally not formed. Okay. So this is your annular ligament. So this is your radial head. Okay. Your radial head hota hai. Ye ulna hota hai. Okay. So you think it says ulna. Okay. Ulna aisa hai. Now there is annular ligament, as a ligament hota hai. Okay, this is totally inside the ligament, as a ligament ke andar hota hai. Okay, if you are pulling this radial head, okay, so ye yahan se skip kar jata hai. So it skip out of the annular ligament. Okay, it is skip out of the annular ligament, and because of the skipping out of the annular ligament, there the pain will start. Okay, so as soon as you the force is in longitudinal or axial force lagate hai, and pronation mein rehta hai. As soon as you supinate. जैसे सुपाइनेट करेंगे तो अगेन